Dobroveče, dobrodošli u Dom kulture Studentski grad na festival indijskog filma. Hvala vam što ste došli u ovolikom broju, znači da nije bilo uzaludno organizovati ovakav festival u našoj ustanovi kulture. Festival počinje večeras i trajeće do nedelje uveče, a sa nama su večeras, prvo bih voljela da predstavim njenu ekscelenciju, Narinder Chauhan, ambasadorku Republike Indije. Hvala joj što nam se pridružila u Domu kulture. Zatim je... Tu je sa nama i Miroljub Stojanović i Igor Toholj, urednik filmskog programa Doma kulture Studentski grad, koji će nam se obratiti i reći nešto više o samom festivalu. Igor, izvolite.
Hvala vam svima što ste večeras ovde u velikom broju. To nije fraza, pošto zaista je teško napuniti danas bioskopsku salu, pogotovo po ovakvom vremenu. I think I shall speak in English, at least I try to. To speak in English. Your Excellency, thank you very much for giving us a pleasure for your visit to the Student City Cultural Center, which is a cultural center within the biggest student campus in the Balkans. It was also the biggest in former Yugoslavia. This institution is almost 45 years old, and we are organizing many cultural events through the year. One of the most important events, I can see it clearly now, doesn't matter, that's the beginning of the year, is the Festival of Indian Film. Considering the fact that it's not film, it's not only the film festival, then also our small contribution in celebration of your national holiday, the Day of Republic of India. My honest congratulations and happy holidays. On the other hand, I would like also to thank you for providing us the contemporary films from Indian cinematography. We all know, we are very well aware how this cinematography is rich and how many films are recorded through only 1 year. So this selection of seven films reflects the main subjects and main topics of contemporary Indian cinema maybe 15 years ago. I will ask you now for a few words, if you like, to address to our audience. Thank you very much. So,
thank you. Namaste, first of all, and I would like to thank you for your presence here today. It's a very cold day, January, snow all around, minus degree temperatures. So it is, I think, a tribute to the Indian cinema that there are such lovers of Indian cinema here in Serbia, and why not? Because we have such a rich history of relationship, and even during present times, we have a relationship marked by mutual trust, understanding, and support to each other on issues of core interest, signified by the recent very successful visit of your Prime Minister to India at the invitation of Prime Minister Modi. And I would also like to thank the organizers for having taken the initiative. What an idea you gave us to celebrate the Republic Day of India. Today is the Republic Day. Last year, on 15th August, we celebrated 70 years of India's independence. And Professor Alexander Petrovich, who has created history, actually, by commencing a course on cultural history of India, at Belgrade University. You know, in former Yugoslavia, Marshal Tito, he was so fond of India that he created the School of Indology in his hometown Zagreb, which has now gone to Croatia. So Serbia was left without an Indology center. And on my arrival here, when I asked Belgrade University, can we have a School of Indology, they said that for that, they would require at least 5 to 6 PhDs. to be registered before they can start a school of Indology, and that would probably take 10 to 15 years. So meanwhile, Professor Alexander Petrovich, he has commenced this course on cultural history of India. I would request you all, if you have time, to please join it from time to time. And he, in fact, asked me, he said, why is it that India is celebrating 70 years when it should be celebrating 7,000 years? That's a very noble thought, and Professor Alexander Petrovich next month would be traveling all over India, and he would be giving lectures on India-Serbia relations and on many other aspects of the Balkans and of Serbia. And thank you very much once again for taking so much interest in Indian films. Hollywood has swept the world, but it has not been able to sweep India, because we have our own brand of films, Bollywood, and this is the largest film industry in the world. And among the options that we had given to the center, I think the films that you have chosen are really, really very good. Today's film, Devdas, is a classic. And it has been played out by two very famous actors, Shah Rukh Khan. He is known as King Khan in India. He is the most highly rated actor. And the female actress is Aishwarya Rai. She was Miss World. And she is a very well-known personality world over, and also a brand ambassador of Longines and many other international brands. She is, and then Madhuri Dixit, of course. I think I really envy you that you all are seeing this movie and tonight, and that you will really enjoy yourself. Now, with these words, thank you very much once again, and I would like to thank the organizers for having chosen 26th January, Republic Day. 15th August is actually our Independence Day, and then our Constituent Assembly sat, and they, within 2 years, they produced the world's most important, and I would say one of the best constitutions of the world, which took the best from all the constitutions. And it is on 26 January that we promulgated our constitution, we brought it into effect, and India became a democracy. And today India is the world's largest democracy, and it's a unique privilege for me as Indian ambassador to be here in Serbia, not only because of the historicity of our relations, but I represent the largest democracy in a country which is one of the oldest democracies. In fact, India House in Belgrade belongs to your first Prime Minister, Mr. Nikola Pašić. With these words, I thank you for your presence once again, and please enjoy the movie.
Thank you. And now I can continue in Serbian, lucky me. Sad bih pozvao Miljuba Stojanovića, našeg starog saradnika, prijatelja, urednika izdavaštva Filmskog centra Srbije, filmskog kritičara i teoretičara, da vas bliže uputi u ovaj izbor filmova u program. Hvala vam.
Dobroveče. Meni je zaista čast i zadovoljstvo, bez prevelike kurtoazije, kao i uvek, da otvorimo ovu reviju indijskog filma. Indijski film je u srpskoj filmskoj sredini i dalje potcenjena kategorija, bez obzira što je ovom milenijumu bilo ne malo sličnih manifestacija. One su uvek dobrodošle, i ono što pre svega treba reći, pre bilo kakvog komentara za ovaj izbor od 7 filmova, da čuli ste njenu ekscelenciju, da je ovo najveća filmska industrija na svetu i u industriji koja proizvodi 1000 pa čak i do 1100-200 filmova, igranih filmova godišnje. Zaista je posebna urednička bratolomija koncipirati ma koji oblik programa koji ima nekakvog kontekstualnog smisla. Ono što treba reći i što je nužna informacija za vas, a ima ih 2-3, pa bi bilo lepo da obratite pažnju ukoliko, a prvo hvala što ste došli u ovolikom broju, jer ovaj izbor filmova to zaista zaslužuje. Nekoliko stvari koje se meni čini jako bitni. Prvo, gledat ćete, kako sam već u dva maha danas imao priliku da kažem, reprezentativan izbor filmova koji pripadaju prvoj ligi indijskog recentnog filma. Znači, ovo nije nikakav kompromisni program. Drugo, vidjet ćete nešto, jedan delić žanrovskog obilja koji postoji u indijskom filmu. Primera radi, jedno od najgledanijih indijskih komedija u ovom milenijumu, Tri idiota, koja je imala enorman komercijalni uspeh. Treća stvar koja je meni lično jedna od najdragocenijih, a mislim da ona jeste međunarodni i svetski reper kad su kinematografska kretanja u pitanju. Ja vas molim da oni koji budu uporni i ostanu obrate pažnju da produkcione aspekte ove kinematografije i vidjet će da su to produkcije i filmovi koji zaista mogu da po svim aspektima produkcionih relacija pariraju hollywoodskim filmovima. Znači, to su filmovi koji su rađeni u velikim studijskim sistemima, filmovi sa vrhunskom tehničkom ekipom, što ne treba da čudi ako neki od nas imaju u vidu da kompletan američki softver Sjedinjenih država drže Hindu inženjeri. Takođe, ne na poslednjem mestu je, čak mislim, najatraktivnije za vas je pojava najeminentnijih glumačkih zvezda indijskog filma. Ako ste obratili pažnju, njena ekscelencija pomenula ime bivše mis sveta Aishwarya Rai, koja se sada zove Aishwarya Rai Bachchan, na koju udaje za najveću ikonu indijskog i bolivudskog filma svih vremena Amitabha Bachchana, najskupljeg azijskog glumca svih vremena. Još nekoliko glumaca, čuli smo da su pomenuti Shah Rukh Khan, to je jedan film u kome igra u Tri idiota, igra jedan od velikana indijske glumačke scene, Amir Khan, koji je potpisao i jedan film u svojstvu reditelja, a takođe je pomenuto ime moje najomiljenije glumice i mislim da to nije moje lično nekakvo zagovaranje njenih vrednosti, Madhuri Dixit. To je najsofisticiranija glumica indijskog filma koji su neki kritičari, da li je pitajte Meryl Streep indijske filmske scene, koja je nakon suverene vladavine Sri Devi, Tamilke s juga 80-ih godina obeležila indijsku scenu 90-ih godina. Znači, sve u svemu, predstoji vam nekoliko odličnih filmova, znači u ovaj izbor ne trebate sumnjati, ja lično bih ga obe ručke potpisao, a što se večerašnjeg uvodnog filma tiče, taj film je jedan od svetskih rekordera po broju remake-ovanja u istoriji. Prva verzija filma Devdas je nastala 1928. godine, još u epohi, bogatoj epohi indijskog nemog filma. Meni lično, i tu verziju smo imali prilike da pre mnogo godina vidimo u Beogradu, je najduža verzija modernog klasika indijskog filma Bimala Roya, koja je nastala 1955. godine i u kojoj igra možda najveći glumac koji ikad živao u istoriji indijskog filma, Dilip Kumar. A, znači, ovo je jedan spektakularan film. Sanjay Leela Bansali ga je potpisao u svojstvu reditelja. Njemu pripada ovo veče otvaranja, kao i veče zatvaranja koje se zatvara sa njegovim takođe spektakularnim blockbusterom filmom u kome ponovo igra Shah Rukh Khan. Inače, omljena glumačko ime mnogih eminentnih indijskih reditelja s kojim rade zaista najprestižniji velikani indijskog filma. I sve u svemu, mislim da ćete zaista uživati i da neće biti promašaja ma koji film budete izabrali. Hvala vam što ste došli i hvala. Prijatno.
Hvala još jednom Miroljubu Stojanoviću, hvala vašoj ekscelenciji. Nadam se da ćemo se vidjeti u velikom broju i tokom ovih sledećih dana i sledećih projekcija. Zaista, da kažem, imate priliku da vidite jedan presek savremenog indijskog filma, 7 filmova, i želim vam prijatnu projekciju večeras. Hvala.